Minecraft blog facts and hacks that are so shocking they broke the internet. No one believes they're real, but I'm going to prove they 100% work. Watch until the end to blow your mind.
Minecraft's end rods used to have a purple base.
Oh, I remember that.
Torches. Sand only breaks on a sideways end.
Wait, sand
end
breaks
end rods
on
used to have
end
a smaller hitbox. You could walk up end rods when they were added.
Really?
They're unused parts of their texture. End rods are held differently in Bedrock Edition.
Why,
water
though?
Breaks end rods in Java Edition.
Wait,
an end rod can
away.
Be worn using commands. End ships
like
have six end rods.
End
rods never spawn facing down. Torches can't go on end rods in Bedrock Edition.
But that doesn't make any sense.
End rods break instantly. The particles are faster in Bedrock Edition. End rods melt.
But they're not hot. Apparently, they have a bunch of secret abilities that I had no idea about. First off being the fact that they can melt snow the same way that torches do, which doesn't make a lot of sense to me because they're not hot. At least I can't imagine them being hot. Like, I always look at Enrod and I think of it like an icy pole. It just doesn't work. But look at that! It's literally melting the snow. I want to see how much of this snow melts. So while it is doing that, guys, I also want to see if sand breaks on it. Can we break this block? Yeah, nah. But that doesn't make sense to me because it's like literally a stick pointing up. You think if sand hits that, it would like spray out everywhere like it would in real life. But then I also want to use it as a unicorn horn because that looked dope, guys. Now, they said you could use a command. I'm pretty sure the command is /item:replace:entity:A with the squiggle around the at symbol P armor.head. So you're putting on your head with end_rod. Let's hit enter. Nay! Okay, I'm just embarrassing myself, guys. But look at this! I can walk around like a mini unicorn. I love that. I can't believe that actually works. Which plant will grow the fastest? Wait, not all Minecraft plants grow at the same speed? Since when? Actually, I need to know the answer to this. Okay, they're growing. Wheat first, then our beetroot over on the side. Next up is carrots, I think. Yes, it is. Potatoes, and then, oh my goodness, you do not want to be stuck with the melon or the pumpkin. Those things are slow. But one of it is just red. They didn't try it again, which means the results could change. So that's what we're going to be testing now to see if wheat is actually the best crop. Wait a minute, guys, hold up. We have a problem. If I start planting these seeds, then whatever I plant first is going to have a head start over the rest. Wait, in the video, they turned tick speed down to zero. We can do the same thing. If we go open up chat and do /game rule, random tick speed and set this to zero, it means plants won't grow at all. So let's do that first. Bang. All right, now that we've done that, we'll place down beetroot on this side. Then we've got our pumpkin, our melon seeds, our wheat seeds, potato, and finally some carrot. All right, so we've got all of our seeds set up now, guys. It's time to get this race going. So let's go ahead and do /game rule, random tick speed, and we're going to turn it up to 500. Are you guys ready? 3, 2, 1, grow! Here we go, guys. The race has begun. Ooh, potato's getting an early start. You guys, what? I think potatoes is going to win here, guys. Potatoes going up, beetroot going up. Oh my goodness, the race is totally different here. Carrots, the melon, potato wins, beetroot second, wheat third, melon fourth, carrots, and then finally our pumpkin. It's totally random, guys. It has to be random. The experiment was totally out. Why don't we do the experiment a second time, guys, and see whether there is a pattern here. Go, 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 go. All right, here we go, guys. The growing has begun. Okay, they're going a little bit slower this time around. Oh, potatoes getting an early start. Maybe potatoes are the way to go here, guys. Melon's going up, beetroot, the wheat's going up too. Beetroot wins this round, then potato in second here. I think wheat's going to come in clutch for the third position. Ooh, the carrot or the melon. Okay, wheat is in third, guys. Oh, there it is. Finally complete. We got the melon and the carrot and the pumpkin haven't even gone yet. Carrot and, wow, that pumpkin is slow. All right. Well, there does seem to be a pattern here, guys. Beetroot and the potatoes are usually faster. Wheat is in the middle here. Carrot and the melon are second. And then the pumpkin is by far the slowest. But yeah, no, certainly wheat is not the fastest crop. So just switch all your crops over to beetroot and potato because they are clearly superior.
Minecraft anvils have the same blast resistance as obsidian.
They are pretty tough.
In Java Edition, anvils can only be pushed while falling.
Wait, while they're falling, you
can't
push them on the ground?
25 uses. Blueboon mansions have forge rooms with a damaged
so you don't have
anvil
to craft them.
A falling anvil from 3 blocks or higher
since
will destroy items
dark.
Below it. Renaming a spawn egg spawns the mob with the name.
What?
Helmets
I have no
reduce
idea.
The damage of a falling
Who
anvil by
Santa?
A fourth. Subscribe for more.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I am certain you are able to push anvils using a piston. I've done it many times before. Surely. All right, there we go. And activate that. Boom. What? Why are you not moving, anvil? Are you kidding me? I'm so sure I pushed an anvil using a piston before. Wait, maybe if we use a slime block in the middle, that will do the trick here, guys. All right, slime block, anvil, and bang! No! Anvils are way tougher than I thought. Yo, that's crazy. All right, now, how are we going to test that falling through the air? Wait, I have an idea for a little bit of contraption. We can use some observers here, guys. All right, how high are we going to need to make this? Pretty high. I think if we go all the way up, we'll just do this all the way up here for to be careful, guys. Then we're going to need two blocks facing that way. That'll detect our anvil. And then we need to go down a bunch of blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I think is the tick speed for an anvil to fall down. And then we'll need to have some stone here. All right, we're doing very big experiments right now, guys. All right, and then we'll build that out. Oh my goodness, we're testing my redstone knowledge. And then some redstone dust out here. We need to have a repeater that's 3 ticks into there. And then the piston will go just below here. Will this work? I don't know, but we're about to find out. All right, let's place our anvil up here. 3, 2, 1, down it goes. It's falling and boom. Oh my goodness, we did push it. We actually pushed it. What? Well, one feature that would actually make sense is if anvils destroyed items if they fell from a certain distance. And apparently that is a thing if they fall from at least 3 blocks high. So there is our anvil, guys. We'll place down our diamonds like so. Drop our anvil down and boom. Yo! It actually crushed my diamonds. Just don't do that in survival. Or you are for certain losing your diamonds, guys. This could honestly be a great troll to pull on your friends if they've accidentally left some items on the ground. You just drop an anvil and run. Finally, guys, you can rename spawn eggs. I always thought you had to use a name tag, but apparently we can just rename the spawn egg and that will rename them up. So we're going to call this guy subscribe because that's exactly what you guys should do for all of these awesome block facts. Let's spawn them in and... Yo! Who needs name tags? Don't waste name tags all your time, guys. Just literally rename the spawn egg and you got yourself a subscribe chicken. Ba-bark! Stop! Moss blocks can be turned into podzol, thus creating an easy dirt farm? Excuse me, what? Since when? You can't make podzol. The only place you can get it is from giant tiger biomes, and I always hate that because I love podzol. I think it's one of the best building blocks, especially for paths, but you can only get in giant tiger biomes, and you're telling me, what, I gotta plant 4 spruce saplings, hit some bone meal and some moss, and... What? If this works, it'll be life-changing for me, guys, because I love building with podzol. It's honestly one of my favorite blocks, but I can never find giant tiger biomes. So apparently, we just need to put some moss in the ground, bone meal that. That gives us a bunch more moss, and now we just need to destroy all of the stuff on top of it, get rid of that moss carpet, the bushes, and the flowering azalea. And then we needed to get 4 spruce saplings, 1, 2, 3, 4, and apparently growing a tree on moss turns it into podzol, which just seems stupid to me, but let's test it first before I make my... What? The tree literally just grew. I didn't even have to bone meal it. And it all turned into podzol. What? Yo, that's insane. Bro, not only do you get one of the giant tiger trees, but you get yourself some beautiful podzol.
Did you know if you get a block of amethyst at the top, a firework rocket at the bottom, it will make this noise.
Hey, what noise? Oh my goodness. That's beautiful. I love it. I am actually in love right now. And what better place to test this other than an amethyst geode? Okay, let's build up a little bit and launch it. Are you kidding me? It didn't reach it. There we go. We've got our blocks all the way up here. Hopefully now we can get the sound. The third time's the charm. Oh my god. That is beautiful. Oh, yo, I love it. I love it. That is so satisfying, guys. Oh my gosh. What is that beautiful block? It's like something straight out of a magic book. Holy moly. It's like going into multiple dimensions. We got the nether, the lush caves. Yo, bro, what? That thing is beautiful. And the deep dark over there. What holy madness is this? Science, physics, nothing can explain this, but I love it. I need that block in my world. That's awesome decoration. Yo, look at that mine shaft. Oh, that's dope. Look at the detail. How did he build with such tiny little blocks, guys? I need this. I need this. Yo, wait, hold up. Wait a minute, he's going through the door and... Wait a minute, that lush cave looks exactly like the one in his block. Wait, what's going on? Wait. He's built all of these in ginormous size? I don't understand. How is this working? I thought he was building using tiny blocks, but maybe not? You guys better subscribe because this took me 5 hours to figure out, guys, and I didn't even manage to make one as big and as awesome as that guy did in his video, all right? I made one that was like a mini size, but look, all right? It's still pretty cool. I still got myself a magical block. We got the lush caves over in here. We got the nether jamming on there, the deep dark, and the amethyst geode on the top. I think it looks absolutely awesome. And look at this, guys. I can even mess around with blocks in the space. So look, I can go ahead and break that netherite block. It's like I've got tiny little block powers. I absolutely love this, guys. You have your own little worlds, but just like the video, check this out. I can jump in and boom. I'm inside the actual thing, and I rebuilt each of these worlds in the tiny little squares. Yes, I know it wasn't as good as his worlds in the video, but come on, guys, I did my best, all right? I tried really hard. Because you can literally just, like, walk through and then suddenly you're in this area. You can use this as, like, a super transport system around your Minecraft world. The only thing is, unfortunately, in trying to figure out how we got this, I also discovered that this isn't normal Minecraft. You are, unfortunately, going to need to install a mod, but I kind of think it's worth it to get this awesome-looking block, but Mojang, please add this as a real block in Minecraft, like a super portal block. That would be so, so dope, guys. But if you want to try this for yourself, you can download this mod. It's called the Immersive Portal Mod, which kind of makes sense, and it is really easy to install, guys, and it's so worth it, because this is just so cool. Why don't we move on to some actually real block facts that don't use any mods? Ooh, okay, we got a bunch of crops. What are we doing? And a pickaxe with Fortune 255. That is insane. Whoa! Look at all of those beetroot seeds. That is crazy. But, I mean, it does make sense. It's not exactly a block fact. If you use Fortune 255, you're gonna get a ton of items. That just makes sense. That's how the enchantment works here, guys. I mean, you can only get 255 enchantment using commands, but you can still use Fortune 3 using an anvil. Okay, and now we've got tons of wheat. What exactly are we showing here, guys? And here is our dead bush, a bunch of sticks. How did he only get one? He's got Fortune 255. Wait, maybe because the pickaxe can only be gotten using commands? A dead bush is secretly immune to magic? How did I never know this? Okay, but maybe it has to do with the fact that his pickaxe was using commands to get Fortune 255. We're just going to use a normal enchanted book to get a Fortune 3 pickaxe. And we will show that it still works with some of the other crops here, guys. So let's go ahead and we'll just plant some potatoes and carrots as an example. Oh, I planted two potatoes. All right, there we go. We wait for those to grow and we'll put our dead bush just over here. You know what? We'll make it fair, even put water next to the dead bush, even though it's dead. Whatever. Don't think about it too hard, guys. All right, we're gonna switch into survival mode here. We're gonna wait for our crops to grow. Potato, grow!
Grow, potato!
Okay, seriously. Okay, guys, can you go any faster? I'm trying to do a video here any day now. I think that is fully grown. All right, let's break our potato and bang, check it out, guys. So even though we got 8 potatoes and then with our carrots here, we got 6 carrots. So the Fortune 3 is working normally. You probably only get 2 to 3 carrots or potatoes. Now we'll try on the dead bush and bang! I didn't even get one stick. Are you kidding me? Fortune actually doesn't work on dead bushes. No kidding. What? Oh, okay, wait. We'll try the command anyway. So give a pin. They used a netherite pickaxe here, guys. And it had an enchantment. So we'll do in... How do you do this? I haven't done this in forever, guys. Enchantments. And then it's... I think it's open square bracket curly ID... Fortune level and then 255 curly bracket square bracket curly bracket 1. All right, I got my super powerful fortune level 255. Bang! I literally only got, I got 2 sticks. I mean, that's better than 1, but fortune doesn't work on dead bushes, guys. Why? How? I don't know. They're just holier, more superior blocks. I don't understand, guys, but what I do understand is that we're out of time with.